Okay guys, so if you notice, my t-shirt is in reverse. All my workout shirts, I always wear them in reverse. Speaking of reverse, I know it looks confusing. Some of the things that are reversed in the world today and can be very confusing is how men show intentions towards women they're interested in. So I want to talk about that today, alright? Now before this, if you really want to know a lot about courtship and dating and romance, go to episode 9, okay? Episode 9 of this Redemptive Rants series. In episode 9, look at the comments and you're going to see a link or two links to two lectures that we did about love, courtship, and marriage. Those are two lectures. Okay, so just to give you a kind of summary nutshell, kind of like a bird's eye view of things. First thing I got to say is this. If a guy, and this is a tip mostly for the women, but the guys should really learn from this as well. If there's a guy who's all words but no actions, a guy who says he likes you, who says a lot of things but have no actions, then obviously the guy's a hypocrite, right? Because he says one thing and does the opposite. So this guy is a hypocrite, cannot be trusted. Now, if the guy is all actions but no words, I would say the guy is a coward, okay? The guy is a coward. Why? Because he's going to do all the actions, and if he feels that you're going to like him back, then he's going to try to see what he can do for you guys to become a couple. But after all the actions and he feels that you don't really like him back, he's just going to ghost you. And he can say, I never got busted because I never said anything, right? So that's a very cowardly way of doing things. So let's just clarify things. Friendship, courtship, then dating. What's the difference? Friendship is purely friendship. If a guy is a true friend, then he will hang out with you in group settings. He's going to avoid the one-on-ones. He's going to avoid private PM, private DM, private messaging. He's going to avoid the one-on-one coffee dates, the one-on-one, let's just hang out over coffee, kind of just you and me kind of stuff. That's not friendly. That's not being a true friend. That's just going to cause confusion, okay? That's the actions without words kind of guy. So my suggestion, if a guy's like that, just avoid the one-on-ones, avoid the semi kind of date but not really kind of fellowships. That's just not worth it. If a guy wants to have genuine friendships, there are many other guys he can be genuine friends with. He doesn't have to do that solo with the opposite sex, okay? So when people say, oh, you know, I have a best friend, he's the opposite sex, I just don't buy that, all right? That's going to cause so much confusion, so many issues can arise from those. So that's genuine friendship. Now, what is courtship? Courtship is when a guy actually says he's interested in you. So let's say I like a girl. After being friends for quite some time, we're going out on group dates or group hangouts, barcada hangouts, group fellowships, when it's a lot of people, and I'm interested in this girl, so I'm going to tell her straight, I really like you. I'm very interested in you. I would like to know if I've got a chance, if we can become more than friends. And the reason why I'm telling you all this is because I'd like to know if I can court you. Now, what does that mean? Courtship basically means I begin to have the right to ask the girl questions, because it's kind of awkward. You're in a group setting, you know, in a group barcada fellowship outing, and then you just ask this girl, so how many kids would you like to have? That's kind of weird, you know? It's like, a lot of people will wonder, why is David asking her how many kids? Is he interested in her, or is this a friendly question? Is he asking for himself or for someone else or for another guy? And if there's a guy who's interested in the same girl, he's going to think, oh, I like her, but does David like her too? Do I have to talk to David about this? As brothers, do we have to have a discussion on whether he's courting her or not? Because if he's not courting her, should I? May I? Can I? So it's just very confusing, right? So when you're in a group barcada situation, you don't ask these really awkward, sensitive, personal questions. But if I ask the girl, can I court you? And she says yes. If I ask her, you know, I'm interested in you, do I have a chance at this? And she says yes. Now I have the right to ask her the sensitive questions, the personal questions, the romantically charged questions. These are the things I can start to ask her. We're not boyfriend-girlfriend yet, okay? We're not yet boyfriend-girlfriend. We are now able to hang out, just the two of us. We can now have private messaging, just the two of us, because my intentions are clear. I'm not being a coward. I'm not being a hypocrite. and I can ask questions. Now, the purpose of courtship is to answer three general questions. And of course, there will be so many questions to answer three. Question number one, are you in the same season? Meaning, are you both wanting to be in a relationship? Are you both looking to settle down, to get married, to be in a relationship? So that's question number one. Are you both in the same season? So after you answer question one, there's question number two. So same season, same values, okay? Values. And just because you're both Christians doesn't mean you have the same values. I've seen this, you know, Christians who say, oh, we're both Christians, but one believes in tithing, the other believes in grace giving. One is a Calvinist, the other is Arminian. One is Pentecostal, the other is cessationist. So there's a lot of issues involved. One is prosperity gospel, which I don't think is Christian at all. That's a fake version of Christianity. That's a false Christianity, okay? But they'll claim to be Christians believing in the prosperity gospel, while the other believes in the stewardship gospel, which is actually the biblical gospel. So first question is same season. Second, same values. Third, same direction. What do I mean by same direction? What if the guy says, I think I'm called to become a pastor, and then the girl says, I don't want to be married to a pastor? Or the guy says, I think I'm going to be a church planter missionary in Saudi Arabia, and the girl says, I have no heart for Saudi Arabia. Like, I just want to be here in the Philippines. So, same, okay, these three have to be the same. Same season, same values, same direction, all right? Now, that's the purpose of courtship. You get to talk about a lot of stuff. You got to ask a lot of questions. You have to find out certain convictions. What do you think about discipline with the kids? Is spanking biblical? Is being strict biblical? What are your thoughts about, relationships and how far you can draw the line when it comes to intimacy? Can we talk about certain topics related to, you know, more sensual things, or should we not? What are your thoughts about bathing suits, wearing bikinis, one-piece, two-piece? What are your thoughts about modesty? What are your thoughts about, complementarianism? What are your thoughts about being in the same church, or husband and wife in different churches? So you guys got to ask so many questions to figure out these three. Because what if you say, yeah, I'm willing to get into courtship, and then the guy's like, you know, I just want to get married in like 3 years, and the girl's like, I want to get married in 10 years. Can you wait? It seems like you both want to get into a relationship, but your values in terms of how long that relationship will last is a little different. Right now, if courtship is all talk, you're all asking questions and answering questions as honestly and sincerely as possible. Courtship is all about talking. If all three are the same, then you enter boyfriend-girlfriend status, okay? Boyfriend-girlfriend status, basically what you're trying to find out is if both of you were telling the truth during the courtship stage. So a lot of times, what happens is like, okay, during courtship, he said he wants to become a missionary to China. But now that we're boyfriend-girlfriend, he's not looking for China, he's not looking at opportunities in China, he's not focusing on his passport, he's not doing any of these things. Or the girl said, you know, during courtship, I'm the type of girl who wants to support her partner. I'm going to be very supportive. And then when they're boyfriend-girlfriend and the guy is trying to, you know, start a business, the girl's like, well, that's your business. I'm not going to touch that. You deal with it on your own. And so what happened to the whole supportiveness thing that she talked about, right? So the boyfriend-girlfriend season is supposed to prove if both of you were telling the truth and have integrity during the courtship. Because if you cannot walk the walk, or you cannot walk the talk, then one of you guys or both of you guys lied during the courtship. All right? So that's basically it. Friendship, courtship, and then boyfriend-girlfriend. I hope this was clear. Again, go to episode 9. Look at the links below if you want to know, if you want to listen to the lectures about this. All right? And I've got several others in this playlist about relationships as well. So check those out. God bless you guys.